I have an amazing story to tell you about here. This Philadelphia man, who was adopted 30 years ago, recently discovered he's on a missing persons list. It turns out that his real father had been looking for him for all these years. Now, the mother disappeared with the son and never came back. Check out, this is the missing persons picture. This is the picture Steve Carter discovered of himself on the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children's website. And that is what the center thought Carter might look like at age 28 based on his baby picture. When Carter saw the picture, he contacted his real father. This is what Steve Carter looks like today. Steve, thank you so much for joining us. It is kind of a strange story. It is difficult in some ways to follow. But first of all, just walk us through this here. How did you discover that you were on a missing kids list in the first place? And why were you checking that?
I actually have to thank CNN for that. I was on a lunch break, and one of your popping news breakthroughs came through, and it was the Carlita White story. She had found herself on the Missing Kids website. So I had a couple free minutes at lunch and went on missingkids.com, pulled up Hawaii 34 years male, and lo and behold, that was the picture that came up.
And Steve, what did you think when you first saw that photo and you recognized yourself?
I thought, minus the mullet, it was pretty much spot on what I look like.
How did you react to that?
It was a bit shocking. I have to tell you, to see yourself and to realize that, you know what, people have been looking for you for that long, I was shell-shocked. At the same time, it was really the first time I'd ever seen a baby picture of myself. So to see that along with a picture of what Mark's Panama would look like at 28 was pretty amazing.
And when you realized that this was you, what did you do?
The first thing I did was I copied the picture, sent it out to a couple friends, asked my friends, you know, who does this person look like? Does it look like me? It was almost, you're in a weird state at the time. Friends said it did kind of look like me. I eventually called my parents, sent them the picture as well, and it was decided that we should probably call the Honolulu Police Department.
And Steve, I understand that you actually went, this led to your real father. Tell me about how you approached him, how you found him, and how he reacted to you.
It took a while for all the blood tests to come back and for me to be confirmed as Mark's Panama Moriarty Barnes. When it did come back, I was a little hesitant to really go forward with the news. I've known since about October of 2011. Didn't really do anything with it. Really wanted to figure out what I wanted to do and how I wanted to go forward with it. It's a lot of information, and it can be quite emotional. So decided to take my time and slowly over the months, worked up the idea that I'd give my biological father a call and also my half-sister. So February of this year, I reached out to both of them.
How did they respond to you? Tell us about that moment. Your father actually realized that that you weren't missing anymore.
There were a lot of awkward pauses, as well there probably should be. It was a big announcement for both. It's a life-changing event, I'd say. We talked about me growing up, what I do now, what he did. It was very eye-opening.
Have you tried to reach out to your biological mother?
My biological mother is actually still missing. They've actually, People Magazine, Joey Bartolomo at People was kind enough to put an age progression photo supplied by the Center for Missing Children of my mother in the article as well, so we could possibly reach out and find her too.
Do you have any memory at all about your past or anything that you jolted in your mind that made you think, I don't belong here with these parents, with this family, I need to be somewhere else?
No, I mean, not at all. I was adopted at age 4, so I pretty much knew that, you know, these were my adopted parents. I had grown up in Hawaii and had known, I mean, ever since I was little, that, you know, I was adopted. So there was no real, I don't fit in here. I fit in very well, actually. I've got two amazing parents, and they did a wonderful job raising me. It was just, on my birth certificate, it was the whole instance from when I went missing to when I was adopted. My birth certificate was created a year later, said my father was a native Hawaiian, and as you can tell, don't really have many of the features that many native Hawaiians do. So, I mean, you always had that inkling that you might not be a native Hawaiian. So after doing, some research, missingkids.com came up, and lo and behold, there I was.
Are you going to keep in contact with your biological father and this new sister that you've now discovered?
Oh, completely. I'd be totally remiss if I didn't take time to meet blood relatives. I think that'd be a big loss for me. So I will definitely reach out, keep in contact, and hopefully meet them someday soon.
Well, Steve, it's really a fascinating story, a happy reunion where I'm so pleased for you. I certainly hope that your biological mother is found at some point, but it does sound like you've reunited, that you now have two families. So thank you so much, Steve, for telling us your story.
Thank you, Suzanne. Have a great weekend.
Okay, thanks. Here's a rundown of some of the stories that we were covering. First, the wives of Osama bin Laden, they're on the move nearly a year after the U.S. raid killed their terrorist husband. We call it the nerd prom. That's when we journalists, celebrities head to the White House for the annual correspondence dinner. Well, I'm going to go there tomorrow, and so is comedian Cedric the Entertainer. So we're going to talk to him about the upcoming dinner. Then Ann Romney talks about the lighter side of Mitt Romney, his hairstyle, what he thinks about the impressions of him on Saturday Night Live.